In this video, I am going to dive into what makes Volbeat not only undeniable geniuses, but also one of metal's most underrated bands. Because behind all of those more radio-friendly jams is a band that respects and embraces some of the heaviest and most important parts of metal's history. Yo, fellow metalheads, my name is Kane Irvine, and this is the heaviest show in the universe. And if you have ever wondered to yourself, dog, Volbeat are so sick, but I seem to be the only one around who actually gets it, well, you're in the right place. I mean, for real, these guys rack up views and listens, but have you ever actually met another Volbeat fan? They're definitely one of those bands where the hits like Still Counting rack up views, but their albums are completely underrated, at least among metal fans. As always, I've hunkered down and listened to their complete discography to really get a grasp of what makes these guys so incredibly unique, enjoyable, and one of the most pleasant listening experiences in all of metal. So be sure to stick around until the end, where I will not only turn otherwise non-Volbeat fans into true Volbeat truthers, but I will also give you the true secret sauce that all the best metal bands use to write the best metal possible, because Volbeat use it too. So this story actually starts out with death metal. Death metal? But Kane, this is Volbeat. They sell hundreds of thousands of albums and only normies listen to them. Well, Volbeat actually started out as a pretty freaking brutal death metal band called Dominus. This was front band Michael Paulson's first band, and goddamn, check this shit out. It is going to plaster the stank on your face permanently. Excellent guitar work and some of the most vicious and brutal vocals I've ever heard. These guys are like a Danish Nile. But I'll get into the heavier, more death metal side of Volbeat a bit later. For now, let's focus on the musical influences that turn them into the hip swinging rockabilly sensation that you and I know and love. Well, at least I love them. You see, Dominus released a number of albums, one of their last being called Vol.Beat, where they started to mellow out and become more of a groove metal band. And it was on Volbeat, the album, that the sound for Volbeat really took shape. You can really hear where Michael was starting to take the sound of the band. It's clear he was growing tired of death metal. He eventually broke the band up to pursue something that could offer him the ability to use all of his musical influences and taste to create a more well-rounded band. Now, I'll be the first to say that death metal can be incredibly diverse in its sound and what it can offer to listeners. But growing up, Michael Paulson was a huge Johnny Cash and Elvis Presley fan, and I don't know if those kind of influences have a place inside of pure death metal. And that's why he formed Volbeat. And goddamn, if fusing that country, hip swinging, rockabilly, classic rock sound with some metal jams was their goal, they did not miss a beat. That song is from their debut album, The Strength, The Sound, The Songs, in 2005, and there they cemented the signature, recognizable Volbeat sound, or how my buddy likes to say. They kept the death metal tuning, tone, and aggression, but relieved themselves of the label that death metal can tend to keep people down with. And it's not often I say that death metal as a genre is holding a band back. I mean, usually it's the opposite, like a band should just switch to full death metal because whatever else they're doing is keeping them from being awesome, fit for autopsy. But truly, this album was such a unique piece of music that we metalheads had never before been lucky enough to hear. It's not often that a band just does their own thing and it sounds completely new and refreshing. Check out some of these other absolute crushers from their first album, including the masterpiece Danny and Lucy, where drummer John Larson takes a classic 50s style rock and roll beat and layers it with Michael's signature Elvis Presley style delivery. The true magic of Volbeat definitely lies in singer and frontman Michael Paulson's early influences growing up. I mean, he grew up around some not very metal music at all. I used to watch a lot of performers. I used to watch this music entertainment program called Let's Rock. Shaken Stevens was a household name on that program at the time, so I became a huge Shaken Stevens fan. Shaken Stevens is a Welsh artist who came to prominence in the UK during the 80s, though his career started in the late 60s. His mix of rockabilly and rock and roll would prove to have a huge impact on Paulson later on. Have a listen. But no other non-metal artist would have an impact on Volbeat and Michael Paulson the way this next one does. One day, my father said to me, "This Shaken Stevens guy, he's just copying Elvis Presley. Well, let me show you the real deal." So he put on some Elvis Presley, and it only took me a few minutes to... His whole personality, the way he was speaking and dressing, he looked like a superhero to me. Anytime Elvis Presley would come on, I would just be... It's clear that both Elvis and Shaken Stevens would go on to have an immense impact on the way Michael writes his music. Especially with the way he delivers his vocals. I mean, he's basically a metal Elvis, but in order to truly grasp what makes Volbeat so special, such undeniable geniuses, we not only need to analyze the non-metal influences that shape them, but also the metal influences and how they weave together to create this unique music. I think the first of which has to be King Diamond. But as unique as his voice is,
I am not a fan.
I think the main influence here are the riffs and song construction. King Diamond and Merciful Fate had such big impacts on the coming thrash, death, and black metal movements, and he even performed a song with Volbeat on the album Outlaw Gentlemen and Shady Ladies. So it's inevitable that he would end up having such a huge impact on Volbeat and their musical style. But it wasn't apparent at first, because as I stated earlier, Volbeat started out as a death metal band called Dominus. So let's take a step back to that era first to get a firmer grip on why Volbeat eventually became the well-rounded band they are today. Volbeat's music is a mix of rockabilly, country, classic rock, and at times brutally heavy metal. So let's take a step back to Michael's first band, Dominus, to get a further grasp on the heavy metal influences that would come to shape Volbeat. And this is where that heavier side of Volbeat really starts to make sense. And for a more mainstream band, they definitely have some brutal riffs in their repertoire. And someone who didn't know their history would really come to question like how this all came together. Dominus starts off with the baseline of all metal, Black Sabbath. When I heard that first riff, I knew I wanted more. Of course, he's speaking of the infamous Devil's Tritone that Black Sabbath first brought to our ears in 1969.
Nice.
And no death metal band's influence is complete without mentioning Chuck Schuldiner and Death, especially those first three albums, which nailed the blueprint for any self-respecting death metal band. He's gone on to list Chuck Schuldiner as one of his three biggest influences alongside Elvis and King Diamond. And his love for metal, its history, and the respect he has for it are proudly represented on stage. Like here, where he's proudly rocking a Bathory shirt with an Entombed patch on the back. Or here, where he's even got a Grave shirt on. This guy knows his metal more so than a vast majority of other bands in the scene. And so this whole package of Volbeat starts to really come together, especially when we factor in the members of their original lineup. When Paulson broke Dominus up, he took guitarist Franz Gottschalk and bassist Anders Kjolholm? Anders Kjolholm. With him and hired another death metal musician in John Larson to play drums. So the first iteration of Volbeat was a bunch of death metal guys that wanted to play some lighter metal. And this mix of death metal musicians mixed with Paulson's very early influences have helped Volbeat rise to the top of the metal food chain. When not headlining their own tours, they're out touring with top acts like Megadeth and Metallica on a consistent basis. And personally, Michael's respect and love for metal's history, for his love of the giants on whose shoulders Volbeat stands on, makes me love this band even more. Because behind those more radio-friendly jams that elitists love to hate on is a love and passion and respect for all things metal. And that's the secret sauce that I mentioned earlier. The passion, respect, and love for metal's history is what makes the best bands in metal truly inspirational. And it's what makes Volbeat undeniable geniuses. Without that understanding, that respect for the forefathers, the music becomes dull, uninspirational, and wholly ununique. And anyone who says that about Volbeat hasn't truly dove into this band and what makes their music tick. Thank you so much for watching, and Volbeat sure is awesome, but if you ever wondered how Death's Leprosy changed the game for death metal forever, you can check that video out here. And if you want to learn more about Swedish death metal, you can check that one out right here. As always, long live metal.